deemed so. Sertel, the daughter of a king, my drops of tears are turned to spots of fire. The devil speed, Cardinal Wolsey. No man's pie is free from his ambitious finger. I see his looks matter against me, his eye reviled, me as his abject object. At this instant, he bores me with some trick. I wonder which bulk of what cage can keep the beneficial rays from entering the earth. Stand forth, and with bold spirit relate what you, most like a careful subject, have collected out of the Duke of Buckingham. Speak freely.
First, it was usual with him. Every day it would infect his speech. That if the king should without issue die, he'll carry it so to make the scepter his. These very words I've heard him utter to his son-in-law, Lord Abergavenny, to whom by oath he meant revenge.
Upon the cardinal!
Please, your highness, note this dangerous conception in this point. Not friended by his wish to your high person, his will is most malignant, and it stretches beyond you, to your friends.
Aha! What so rank? Aha! This man is full of mischief. Cast I say further?
If, quoth he, I for this had been committed. As to the tower, I thought I would have played the part my father meant to act upon. The usurper Richard, who being at Salisbury, made suit to come in his presence. Which if granted, as he made silent of his duty, would have put his knife to him.
A giant traitor!
After the Duke, his father, with the knife, he'd stretch him. And with one hand on his dagger, the other spread on his breast, mounting his eyes, he did discharge a horrible oath, whose tenor was, were he evil used, he would outgo his father by as much as a performance. Dozen a resolute purpose.
There's his period, to sheath his knife in us. He is attached. Call him to present trial. If he may find mercy in the law, 'tis his. If none, let him not seek it of us. By day and night, he is traitor to the height. Buckingham shall lessen this big look.
The devil's speed, Cardinal Wolsey.
Heaven's peace be with him.
Did you not of late day hear a buzzing or separation between the king and Catherine?
Yes, but and held not. But that slander, sir, has found a truth now. 'Tis held for certain the king will venture at it. 'Tis the cardinal, and merely to avenge the emperor on her. This is purposed.
I think you've hit the mark, but it's not cruel. The cardinal will have his will, and she must fall.
She must fall.
She must fall.
She must fall.
Thank you. shall not be my judge, whom yet once more I hold my most malicious foe, and think not at all a friend to truth, for it is you have blown this coal betwixt my lord and me, which God's due quench. But you're a master wed me to. Nothing but death shall ever divorce my dignities. Heaven is above all yet, cardinal. There sits a judge no king can corrupt. Therefore I say again, I utterly abhor ye from my soul. Refuse you for my judge.
I do profess you speak not like yourself, madam. You do me wrong. I have no spleen against you, nor injustice for you or any. I do beseech you, gracious madam, to unthink your speaking, and to say no more.
Sir, I am about to weep, but thinking we are a queen, certain the daughter of a king. My drops of tears of turned sparks of fire.
I have touched the highest point of all my greatness. And from this full meridian of my glory, I shall fall.